It starts with believing in the potential of each and every student. No exceptions.
Black excellence is the district's unapologetic stand in support of our African American students thriving and excelling.
It reflects black excellence because it helps me in the community that I live around, helps me stay out of the streets.
Me being a business owner would be a leader, and people could see and reflect of what I'm doing and try to learn from me and try doing that as well.
I want to show the world that you can be anything you put your mind to as a black African American.
It's just for me, black excellence is a really powerful thing, because we don't actually see many people with things that represent black excellence. So I chose a rose, a lion, and a strong arm, because all of these represent someone who has strength, beauty, and power in them. My name is Jenny Maldonado, and I'm in eighth grade at Tokyo Middle School.
My goals reflect black excellence because there's not enough black teachers in schools these days.
My goals reflect black excellence because I want to break stereotypes.
You know, the relationships I build with kids, they believe in me, I believe in them, and when I see them make any kind of improvements, even when they learn from a mistake and they learn from it, that puts a smile on my face, because it's okay, now we know what we need to do, right? So I guess I just love just to be supportive for them.
Don't touch my crown, my mane, my personal journey. I don't think you guys understand how important our hair is to us. When my hair looks bad, I feel bad. And when my hair looks good, I feel good. Hair may be just attached to our heads, but to us, it's more than that. To us, it's attached to our souls.
I will be the first person in my family to graduate high school and actually go and attend college and graduate college and make a career out of myself. So I feel like that reflects black excellence in my family.
It doesn't put me in the stereotype. It shows people that black people aren't just one thing. You can be whatever you want to be.
Excellence means to me how black kids have potential. If they can just discover their true power, they can do anything. When I looked at my family, I thought that they were going to be the perfect model, because first of all, they're always super, and they always have my back. My mom made sure I have everything that I need for school, and she was the one who was helping me. She was so proud of me when I started this. And my brothers and my sister, Afu, Amam, and Sekum, they're my siblings, so of course I was going to include them. First of all, Sekum always cleans the house, and she's an honor student. And my brother, he loves to play with me. And when he plays with me, he makes sure that everyone's included. And Amam, he loves to play. He's very truthful. People who I most look up to are my family.
My name is Atu, and I'm in third grade, and I go to Sherwood School.
I am Dejan Dillard. I am a current senior at Memorial High School. I love to dance, obviously. I spend most of my time in the studio or just dancing at home.
I feel that when I joined, it made a huge impact on our school, because our school isn't used to seeing a black male dancer. like performing for them for a football game or a basketball game. So I feel like it came to them once they were shocked about it, and it's just always been there ever since I joined.
It's hard, it really is, because like the attention is mainly on me, and like I also get a lot of negativity from like boys because they didn't like appreciate watching a male dance, you know. But I want to break that barrier because I feel like we can, you know. At first, I was going to try out for proms in sophomore year, but a former person said that I couldn't do it because no boys were allowed on the team. And then I found out they had got a new coach. So I asked her, was it okay for me to try out? And she thought it was okay. And shockingly, I made the auditions, and it just went from that point on.
It's the first time Memorial's ever had a male dancer on the pom-pom team. And I'm sure at first it was a little out of his comfort zone when he came to tryouts, but he completely surpassed any expectations that we had for a male dancer coming into this team. He is always giving 110% of his energy to practice. He's always bringing joy to the team and making things fun. Having a male on the team is very different, but at the same time, he has just fit right in with the team and become one of them, and they embrace him for that, and it's a very well-gelled team because of that.
Our captains choreograph our pom routines, so they came to me for hip-hop, and I helped them choreograph our hip-hop routines.
I'm very strong at improvising with hip-hop. Like, I can just do that off the top of my head. Like, it's very easy to me. But I'm trying to step out more with ballet and jazz, you know, just to, like, be well-rounded for all the categories.
We perform for basketball and football routines. I personally like basketball better. I just love how, like, the people are more up close to you so they can actually see us dance.
Dancing is just like, it's just a spark in me that I like love. Like, there's nothing negative about it whatsoever, you know? So like, it's just my go-to whenever I'm like in a down mood or having a bad day. Like, I can never like go wrong with it. So I just like love doing it. I will hope to take it to a level when I can start my own dance academy, because I feel like I love young children, I love to dance, so I feel like what would be better, you know? And I feel like it would be a great thing to do, like make a change for like African-American kids, you know, who wants to dance.